just fashionably late, as when am I not? Hi. Let's just start with a song. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. I'm not sleepy, and there is no place I'm going to. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. In the jingle jangle morning, I'll come following you. Yes, I know that evening's empire has returned in the sand, vanished from my hand, left me blindly here to stand, but still not sleeping. My weariness amazes me, I'm landed on my feet, I have no one to greet, and this ancient empty street's too dead for dreaming. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. I'm not sleepy and there is no place I'm going to. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. Jingle jangle morning, I'll come following you. Light hair, laughter, spinning, swinging madly across the sun. It's not aimed at anyone, it's just escaping on the run. But for the sky, there are no fences facing. If you hear vague tracings of skipping reels of rhyme to your tambourine in time, just a shadow that's behind, and it's a clown that you are saying that is chasing. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. I'm not sleepy and there is no place I'm going to. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. Jingle jangle morning, I'll come following you. Now take me disappearing through the smoke rings of my mind, down the foggy ruins of time, far past the haunted beach and the empty frightened trees, out to the far past the twisted reach of crazy sorrow. Ready to go anywhere, I'm ready for the fade into my own parade. Let me forget about today until tomorrow. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song. Hey, Mr. Tambourine Man, play a song for me. In the jingle jangle morning, I'll come following you. And good evening. Yesterday morning, I woke up and Sally, she's over there, but if I point the camera at her, she'll get me. She believes that Facebook may steal her soul. This could be not a total fantasy. She says to me, she never says good morning. She says what she's been thinking about for 3 hours waiting for me to wake up, and it's, why don't you do a sing-along online? And here we are. She said, why don't you do it tonight? Worked through it, got the idea going, okay. And said, I need more prep tomorrow. And I'm glad I did that, because it took about 3 hours to just figure out how to adjust my browser. And it just says, you know, hey, just click this button here on Facebook and you're streaming live. But no, you're not. Not if you set it so that nobody can access your camera. I mean, do you want the internet to access the camera in your laptop? Huh? Okay, that's your thought for this moment. I have no order to these songs. The intention is, you know, nothing real heavy duty, just some stuff that you may be familiar with and sing along. It's very nice. I probably even missed some people that are here. Hi.
Howdy.
Okay, cool. Let me see. Kylie, when you buzz me in that Joanne is there, we will sing her request. We have one request so far, except for the 11 from my wife. They're not always requests either. If one knows what one is, you know, when mama is happy, everybody is happy. Yes. I have no idea what voice I'm doing there. Some folks say a man's made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood, skin and bone. A mind that's weak in the back, that's strong. You know, 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me blind. My soul to the company store. You may have noticed I was just reading that Kylie said, Mom is here too. And I blew a line. I do not multitask. Born one morning in the drizzling rain, fighting and trouble, that's my middle name. If it seemed to come again, better step aside. A lot of men didn't and a lot of men died. 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in that same. Don't you call me, I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, sun didn't shine. I grabbed my shovel and I went to the mine. I dug 16 tons of number 9 coal. Straw boss hollered, damn your soul, you lose 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older, deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. See me coming, just step aside. A lot of men did and a lot of men died. I won the first of iron, the other of steel. One don't get you, oh, the left one will. 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. Don't you call me, I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.
Okay.
You have recognized the... quiet during the applause, right? We have no idea. Okay, here's a bit. This won't even be funny. Oh, dear. Maybe I shouldn't digress, but I always do. Here, two digressions. I was delivering a pizza once at some place in Hollywood, and behind me on the other payphone...
Yeah, this is Ernie Ford. I'm going to be over there in about half an hour with 12. The table for 12. And we're all men.
What do you mean we're all men? Like we're going to go in the smoking room? We're going to all come in the front entrance? I've pondered over that for, it's not 40 years yet, but it is. Yeah, I was like, you know, 28 maybe at the time. That would be 40 years ago and a little bit. 2 days past 73 here. I forgot the other digression. Oh, I'll come back to it later. I'll digress and mention it then. Okay, so Joanne, you're there. We are now rung in from Ireland through the U.S. and around to Australia. How about that? This little concert here, if it's a concert, it's a sing-along. But it's for all of you people that, like, I say,
my band will be playing in Middleburg tonight.
And I get a like from Texas and three likes from California. I think, well, they're not going to come, are they? Here you all are. Wow. Okay. I know what song. Yes, here. This is it.
Tell them what key.
What key?
In case they have a guitar.
In case you have a guitar and that maybe I'm still in, it's in C, I think. Unless I change my mind. By the way, this is just so you know this. What I say comes to you about a minute later. So there'll be a little bit of inaction on the interaction here. I will glance at those things down the right side. Okay. It doesn't say mom is here. It says mum is here. That's right. I'm speaking to people who think my name is pronounced Dennis. And they're right. Okay. I haven't sung anything in a while. I've been yakking, haven't I? Some sing-along. I am going up a step. I can do that without a capo. I can transpose to D. How once a jolly swag man sat beside the billabong under the shade of a coolibah tree, and he sang as he sat and waited by the billabong. You come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Sang as he sat, waited by the billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Down came a jumbuck to drink beside the billabong. Up jumped the swag man and seized him with glee. And he sang as he stuffed the jumbuck in his tupper bag. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. He sang as he stuffed the jumbuck in his tupper bag. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Up came the troopers, riding on the thoroughbreds. Down came the stockmen, one, two, and three. Where's the jolly jumbuck you got in your tucker bag? You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Where's the jolly jumbuck you got in your tucker bag? You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Up jumped the swag man and plunged into the billabong. You'll never catch me alive, cried he. And now his ghost may be heard as you drink beside the billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. That's you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Where's the his ghost may be heard as you drink beside the billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Hi, Howard. You look different than I remember you. Of course, I was about 10 years old then. Weren't we all? This is not true. I was 17 when he was 10. Okay. Hi, Roger. Andrea Farley. Hi, Donna. Okay. Where was I? Ah, okay. That should take me back to the 60s, except it's the early 60s. Not the, yeah, maybe it's the late 50s. Oh, I recall it was the year of the pig at the baby. Okay, none of you know what that's a quote from. We'll see what you get if you can.
If only I had written this back then.
That would not be reduced to broadcasting on Facebook.
Yes, sure, but there are no concerts now.
That's no concerts now. Okay, yes, I would be broadcasting on Facebook. But it would be monetized, at least. Unless I was a good guy, like Neil Diamond, and we'll get around to him. George Wallace stood in the doorway. He drew him a line in the sand. Now the president told those children, just you walk on by that man. Oh, won't you walk on by that man? Oh, honey, walk on by that man. When he said to you, what you cannot do, walk on by that man. George Wallace, he was a short man, 6'2" John Kennedy stand. Oh, but short or tall makes no difference at all. Walk on by that man, just you walk on by that man. Won't you walk on by that man? When he said to you what you cannot do, walk on by that man. And now listen to me, children, when they tell you what you can, and they tell you what you cannot do, just walk on by that man. Oh, won't you walk on by that man? Well, walk on by that man. When he said to you what you cannot do, walk on by that man. Sing it one more. Walk on by that man. Oh, won't you walk on by that man? Oh, when he said to you what you cannot do, walk on by that man. By golly, I was singing a much dumber song than that. Well, it was white, actually. It was rude. It was sacrilegious. It's a song called Ain't No Flies on Jesus. That's all I'm going to quote you of it. But once in Schenectady, I don't remember what the place was called. It might have been the steak and ale. It could have been the beef and the brew. It could have been the, you know, the lamb and lager. It could have been one of those. Might not have. And I got going at, and the room was going, and all clapping their hands. And I got off the stage, and I led a line of people out one door, onto the sidewalk, back in the other door, all the way up the length of it, and onto the stage again. Ha! That happens once in a while. Nobody else remembers that, though. That's your life. It's ephemera. It's all up here and other places. Okay. All right. Now that Nancy and Jeremy are both here, they were there one of them, not the last time, but one of the times I did this song. This is the worldwide universal song, Cudgel Your Little Brains. By the time you post an answer there, the grog, maybe. It was right down at the bottom of Schenectady before it becomes, what's it, college, Schenectady County Community College. Little triangle of lawn out in front of the place. Grog doesn't sound totally impossible. So, this is, it's like working in a bar, except that the back chat is very quiet, and I, you know, but you can all see it too. If you're following that. Now, I was telling an anecdote. Okay, this song. And now you've had time to think about what it might have been. This song I have sung at a dog show in Scotland where it saved my bacon, because I had just sung another song about dogs that is slightly rude in America and is hilarious. And I'm thinking, oh man, I've got like 200 dog fanciers here. Wait till they hear this. And it was sort of like what Christopher Shaw likes to call golf claps.
You're on the seventh fairway. It's a 9-iron up to the dog leg, and it stays in bounds. Dog claps. That's not dog claps, it's golf claps. So it turns out it's really rude in Scotland. But I came back with this song, and then they liked me again. Whew. You sing in places where there are different societies, you check out the mores first. Oh, this song, I've sung it in Scotland. I have sung it hanging off the back of a
camera.
a catamaran, I think. I was trying to think of trimaran. No, a bimaran. No, I know it's not called a bimaran.
Go from dogs to cats.
Thank you. Dogs and cats are like bimarans?
You moved from dogs now to cats, catamaran.
I've moved from dogs to cats. Do you know that I once received a cat call. I'd been talking to my cousin, and 2 a.m, I get a call back from her. And there's nobody there when I pick it up. I say, was something urgent? I called her back. It's 2 a.m, now I'm calling her. She says, hi, weren't we just talking? I say, yeah. She says, why did you call? I said, you just called me. She said, no, I didn't. My phone's just sitting up there on the counter. And I said, do you have a cat? Okay, we've had butt calls, we've had purse calls, and now we've had a cat call. And if I talk any longer, I'll probably get one here. And the other place, I was hanging off the back of a catamaran in the Caribbean with an audience who were all hanging on noodles.
True.
And I have and I have sung this in an elementary school in a village, not much more than a village, way up in the Andes. And a couple of those little kids knew this. Okay, here it is. What key do I sing this in? We'll try it here. Yeah, no, we'll take it up slightly. No, we won't. Never mind. Sometimes I should draw a little, you know, the little window shade down over my mind instead of just saying everything that passes through.
Oh, God, please.
Where it began, I don't begin to know it. Oh, but I know it's going strong. It was the spring, and spring became the summer. Yeah, well, that love's still going on. Hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Oh, sweet Caroline, nothing ever seems so good. I'd be inclined to believe it never would, but now I look at the night and it don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two. And when I hurt, hurt runs off my shoulders. How can I hurt when I'm with you? Warm, touching warm, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Oh, sweet Caroline, nothing ever seems so good. I'd be inclined to believe it never would. Caroline, it ever seems so good. I'd be inclined believing never would. Hands, don't touch hands, don't touch me, I won't touch you. Caroline.
never would. Sweet Caroline.
And God bless Neil Diamond. He's a good guy. He just threw that out on Facebook or somewhere. It got passed along to us. I don't know. Maybe it was last week. Maybe it was this morning. And I have stolen his new ending. He's just, you know, sitting there. He's got a beard now. He doesn't look like himself at all. Sitting on a bench or a chair,
with his dog.
About like that on the guitar. I think he's more a piano player. But there he was, just being him, being a good guy, with his golden retriever.
Washing hands.
Okay. All right, let me see. Okay. Hi, Pam. Hi, Tara. All right. Hi, Vani. What we got? We got
Henry and Alaire.
Oh, we got Henry and Alaire. Well, they're presumably... Yes, hi, Henry and Alaire. How you guys? I hope you're not... Actually, you got to be the least bored couple of kids. Your mother posts online all the time what she is doing. I'm just grabbing my capo. I didn't even go out of screen, did I? Now I'm going to drink my water. Stay hydrated, just because it's good for you. Okay. Henry and Alaire are like 5 and 9, 4 and 9, something like that. And
10.
And 10? Alaire is 10. Beg your pardon, Alaire. Is it only 10? Is she 11 yet? Never mind. I'm back. Okay. And I was not planning to sing Tara and Alaire, was I?
No.
Or even Henry. No, I was planning to sing. Well, we don't even know. Yes, okay. We're going to go into the memorial section now. And we just will. And this is... I'm going up one step. I may be sorry for this. Kenny Rogers. Also a pretty cool guy, as near as I know. Wrote a neat book long ago, How to Make It with Music, which was how to start out as some little band called the... who was it that crawled into that paper bag? Okay, you know who I mean. I just dropped in to see what condition my condition was in. I don't know why I never learned that song. I think it's clever, and it's a total pastiche of brainwave music, and it was written by one of your standard Nashville country guys. So, Kenny Rogers, after doing a hell of a lot, has departed. So, on a warm summer's night, on a train bound for nowhere, met up with a gambler. We was both too tired to sleep. We took turns watching out the window at the darkness till boredom overtook us. He began to speak. Said, son, I made a laugh watching people's faces and knowing what the cards are just by the way they hold their eyes. And if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of that whiskey, I'll give you some advice. Well, I passed across my bottle and he drunk down my last swallow. And then he bummed a cigarette. And then he asked me for a light. And the night got deathly quiet and his face lost all expression. He said, gonna learn to play the game, boy. You better learn to play it right. You got to know when to hold them, know when to fold them, know when to walk away, and know when to run. Never count your money
When you're sitting at the table, you got time enough for counting when the deal's done. Now every gambler knows that the keys to surviving is knowing what to throw away and knowing what to keep. Every hand is a winner and every hand is a loser, and the best thing you can hope for is to die in your sleep.
We have to take an intermission in this song. I forgot to plug my not very powerful batteried laptop in. Can you? It's underneath the Tyrannosaurus, more or less, on the table. Okay, I was gonna throw a little intermission, a plugging intermission in after this song, but it seems as though maybe it better happen now. So you brush up on your words to the chorus. Here we go. That'll make it. Thank you. Sally is my equivalent of the gal in the red jacket in the Hilton ads that not only people that knows what your drink is, that kind of stuff. Yes, it's plugged in. Okay, I've looked at my icons. But according to this ad, if you're the band and you break a string, she grabs your guitar and restrings it. And except for the red jacket, Sally has done that any number of times. I am grateful. And that's just, you know, a skim of what I'm grateful for. We won't go into this now. I'm sure I'll mention her many times in this and future broadcasts. Futurecasts. So, where were we? You got no end to hope. No, because every hand is a winner. Every hand is a loser, and the best thing you can hope for is to die in your sleep. Well, then he finished speaking and turned back to the window, crushed out his cigarette, drifted off to sleep. Somewheres in the darkness, that gambler, he broke even. But in his final words, there was an ace I could keep. Got no one to hold them, no one to fold them, no one to walk away, no one to run. You better count your money when you're sitting at the table. There's time enough to count when the deal's done. You better go when to fold them, know when to hold them, know when to walk away, and know when to run. Count your money, but not sitting at the table. It's time enough for counting when the dealing's done. Yes, it's time enough for counting when the dealing's done.
Just had visions of him with 20 of his closest friends standing 3 feet away, politically correctly, or maybe six, each throwing an ace in on top of the coffin.
Huh. All right. I hope you could all hear that. We have a pretty good microphone plugged into the laptop. Okay. I want to say that I had the grace and you know, whatever, just before it became a hit, I was coming back from a gig in the North Country and I heard it on a jukebox. And hey, Rachel, hey, Brad, glad you're there.
Heard it on the jukebox.
What there? Oh, it was on a jukebox. I said, that's a good song. And the way I used to learn songs, I had one of these Sonys, you know, cassette deck, and I just went over and I played it a couple of times and I recorded it holding the deck up to the jukebox. And then I would drive around in my rather noisy Volkswagen playing these songs back and going over line by line and memorizing stuff. And I would also, since the Volkswagen was noisy, I had to put this up to my ear and drive with one hand. Okay. They can't They can't, like, retroactively get you if you admit that, like, 35 years ago you were driving with one hand.
Right? No, you didn't have a cell phone, so it's okay.
Okay. Well, it wasn't. I could say it wasn't talking back to me, but I was listening. And I'm sure I said things like, you know, what the... Was that lying? Okay. And... Light. Light, but in memoriam for our recently departed and greatly missed horse Snickers. Old Stewball was a racehorse. I wish he was mine. Never drank water. He always drank wine. The fairgrounds was crowded. Stewball was there. And the betting was heavy on the bay and the mare. His bridle was silver. His mane, it was gold. The worth of his saddle has never been told. I bet on the bay horse, I bet on the gray. If I'd have bet on old Stewball, I'd be a free man today. Dancing and prancing ahead of them all. Up yonder came my noble Stewball. That night at the clubhouse, Stewball was there. I'm going to play a fake instrumental and think of this next verse, which you cannot look up. I wrote it. I got it. Key line, key word. That night at the clubhouse, Stewball got stewed. You know what's just happened to me in my guitar playing? Got stewed after 5 or 6 packs. He got up and danced nude. He hit on the gray mare. She turned with a flounce. The Stewball persisted, and so he got bounced. He walked up the alley like he was drugged, and down by the water trough, poor Stewball got mugged. He woke up next Wednesday on the Florida train. Instead of his mane, his bridle's clothesline, it trailed on the ground, and the rest of his saddle
has never been found. All Stewball was a racehorse. I wish he was mine. Never drank water. He always drank wine.
This nice island shirt that I'm wearing is, believe me, wishful thinking. So's this. Gotta tune it. There it is. We sang this all fall in the band. Saying, last time we're going to sing it. Last time we're going to sing it. Finally was the last time. January, started playing it again. First time we're going to sing it. We've got to push things along here. I have no idea if I'll be able to do these with the band. I'd love to do this every week. So, might aim for that. I will put out announcements and, spread the word. If you enjoy this, or you think somebody else would, what the heck? I'm not going to digress another time to tell you about audiences and the size of them and whether people go out at night or not.
Just an
anecdote for another day. Okay, my editor is sitting over here. Oh, the song, yes. We'll see. It'd be so much fun to do this with the band, but we will have to see how that's going to work, or if it's going to work. Maybe next year. Summertime, and the living is easy. Fish are jumping. Water is high. Oh, your daddy's rich, and your mama's good looking. So hush, little baby, don't you cry. One of these mornings, you're gonna rise up singing. Spread your wings, take to the sky. But till that morning, oh, nothing's gonna harm you. With Daddy standing by. One of these mornings, hey, you're gonna rise up singing. Yeah, spread your wings, take to the sky. But till that morning, nothing gonna harm you. With Daddy and Mammy staying by. here's a little punchier one. This is a nice drinking sing-along. Hi there, Pete. Just in time to say goodnight. Not quite. Okay, a couple more tunes here. This is a vastly reworked Rabbit McKay song for any of you from Southern California who know that name. I don't necessarily see anybody on the list there that would, but you don't know. The cult album is Bug Cloth Music. It's not a dry cough. It is lifelong phlegm in the throat. Those dropouts when I can't think of the word, not Alzheimer's. I've been doing that since I was 7. When I was a lad of 12, thought myself a swell. I signed aboard as cabin boy on the good ship Fare Thee Well. On my final night ashore, I could not sleep a wink. So I crept into the mermaid's tail to watch the sailors drink. There sat old Folksome John, white hair round his head. He called, "Now gather round me, lads. Here is what he said." He said, "Fill your glasses high, boys. Drink up all you paid. Tomorrow night the harbor lights may be 100 miles away." Said, "You know I served as mate aboard the whaler Mary L. With Captain Kane we sailed her the long way round the hell. 6 years in the islands, boys, 3 years round the pole, till we ghosted home with half a crew, 40 barrels in the hold. And I never saw a sight so strange as old Nantucket shore. So far and seemed the hills of home that I should stay no more. On the night we landed, I spent my 9 years' pay. 4 days from that morning, boys, I shipped from here away. So fill your glasses high, boys, drink up all your pay. Tomorrow night the harbor lights may be 100 miles away." Now these harbor towns are vicious, but the harbor gals are fine. They cover you with kisses and they smother you with wine. They always call you honey when they know you're on the sail, and they've always
got your money, boys, by the time you land in jail. So fill your glasses high, boys, drink up all your pay. Tomorrow night the harbor lights will be 100 miles away. We should not grow thirsty, boys, if it were not for the ale. And we should not go a-roving if it were not for the sail. If it were not for Lonely Jack, there would be no women then. And if not for the foreign shore, we should not sail home again. We did not grow old, boys, we should have no youth. And if young men told no lies, we should not know the truth. In truth, if not for winter's blast, we should not feel warm. And if not for a warm west wind, we should not know the storm. If it were not to sail the storm, no ship would brave the sea. And if it were not for ship and sail, God had not made me. So fill your glasses high, boys, drink up all your pay. Tomorrow night the harbor lights may be 100 miles away. Then old John, he drew me forth, bought me my first ale. It's not that once, but many times again I heard his tale. 'Tis 50 years this morning since the fare thee well set sail. The harbor pilot brought us out, intent upon the whale. And I in turn spent my life bumped before the mast. So if you sail on this morning's tide, to you I raise my glass. And fill your glasses high, boys, drink up all your pay. Tomorrow night the harbor lights may be 100 miles away. Tomorrow night the harbor lights may be 100 miles away. 100 miles away.
Well, greetings to you newcomers. I'm going to go a few minutes longer. And just a couple more closing up songs. And I'd like to do this next week. So I'm enjoying it. If this is a better time slot for more people, speak up. Let me know. I'm going to drink my water again. All right, I'm going to stick my neck out. Got to do a few minutes for you folks that just got here, so belated. Yes, didn't know it was a time-limited concert. All right. No comment, just this song. This is the most, I think it's the most recent song I've written. It's not too long ago. I don't think anything's happened between. I don't write lots of songs. And I've been getting a handle on this kind of slowly. So. Okay. I said I was going to do it, so now I am, right? I realized normally I'd put a couple slow ones in between or take a break now. I'm just going to throw this in. Let me see if I've got a handle tonight. out of tune. I think this is a cheap set of strings. There are places you can spend, you know, $4 for a string, and there are places you can get two sets for $4. And now we know why. Still not paying any $4 for a string. I was drinking in a dive in Cairo, on the wrong side of the Nile, when a shake and a rake and a long black snake come in the door, single file. Well, the shake started making an arms deal, and the rake was trying out his new leer. And the reptile smiled without any guile and slithered round, cadging beers. Next came a clatter and commotion, spotlights stabbing all around. Was a chopper with a hopper full of Interpol coppers. I said, oh, something is going down. I ran way out in the desert just to get away from the place. There was sand on demand on every hand, and I tripped on a mummy case. Well, the case was the shape of the pharaoh, black as an obsidian cup. I got a Jones in my bones for some scarab stones. I said, maybe I'll just open it up. I fiddled the hasp with my church key. The hinges screamed right out loud, praying the purse would come first. Way before the curse, I tore away the shroud. Well, a dust cloud rose from the mummy when it blew away. Ain't no fib that his nibs was flashing his ribs. And the thought I heard somebody say, no meat on the mummy. That's what the hot wind moans. No meat on the mummy, just bones, bones, bones. Well, now I was thinking old King Tut there might sit up and offer to shake hands, so I determined to sashay. I skedaddled, all rattled, up the creek with a paddle, and I could hear it all of the way. No meat on the mummy. That's what the hot wind moans. No meat on the mummy, just bone, bone, bone. Ooh, bone, bone, bone. Well, I bombed back by the busy barroom boys, a big, big bad bob for a brew. All the bells and scales on their cells, texting everybody they knew. No meat on the mummy. That's what the hot wind moans. No meat on the mummy, just bone, bone, bone. Okay. I think we're going to sing one more. I hope I'm in voice for it. It just seems like the right thing to do tonight. And we will go from there. And see you maybe next week. And I might even work up to some actual, you know, coffee house designed, meaningful, emotional storyline.
Like American Pie.
'Re not coffee houses anymore, by the way. They are listening rooms. Okay. I'm going to have to find a key in my head here. Pardon me, I'll be meditating. I have a tarp case.
Oh, I think my spine is stuck in this.
I tell you, I can still sing. I can talk. I can think. We are not our grandparents. in that sense, you know, we're younger minds, but a line came to, well, I am walking my age. And if that's not a song line, you may all write your versions of it. I may write mine. Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grain, for purple mountains' majesty above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, and crown thy good with brotherhood, from sea to shining sea. Till next time.
Peace.